This video is sponsored by NordVPN. And just like this BMW Z4's roof shields you from the elements, NordVPN protects you from hackers and cybercriminals stealing your personal data. That's why we use NordVPN to protect our YouTube channel. And because we teamed up with NordVPN, you get 75% off a 3-year plan and 1 month for free if you use the code OTATOPNL and go to nordvpn.com/OTATOPNL or use the link in the description. And just like the quad-turbo BMW X5 M50D you're about to see in this video, it is super fast. You can switch between 5,200 plus servers in 62 countries in the blink of an eye. Keeping your location hidden and your data protected and being able to access content not available in your own country. So go to nordvpn.com/OTATOPNL or use the link in the description and use the code OTATOPNL and protect yourself today. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by OTATOPNL. My name is Max, and today we've got the all-new BMW X5, and we've got the fastest, most powerful one of this moment. We've got the M50D, so we've got the performance diesel version with 400 horsepower and 760 newton meters of torque. So it is the quad turbo inline six diesel engine, which is a peach if you ask me. I really love this drivetrain. So today we are going to find out how it feels in the new X5, because we've driven it in the 5 series, but this of course is a lot heavier. It's about 2200 kilos. So we're going to see how it behaves, how it feels, if it feels as powerful as it should. I'm going to do a walk around, show you the car, show you the spec we've got it in, then drive it along this road, do a performance measurement over there, and take it to the Autobahn for a quick blast over there. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to receive updates when we upload a new video, and follow us on Instagram at OTATOPNL. Alrighty, let's get started. So the color, we've got it in Piton Blau today. It's this really clear blue color. It's like an M color, sort of. It's like the calipers on the M Sport brakes. We've got 22-inch M Performance wheels. You get them standard if you get an M50D. We've got all these accents. I always forget the color. Ferric gray. I think it's ferric gray, or it used to be ferric gray and they changed it to something. But you get these details around the car if you get an M Performance version. What else? Well, we've got still maybe a little bit too much chrome on this car. It's a very friendly version, this. And that's a good thing and it's a bad thing, sort of. But because we have this grille also in that same color, these details in the front bumper, the wheels are sort of the same color, the side blade, the mirror caps, we've got the chrome or brushed aluminium on the windowsills. We don't have tinted windows, which I think is a shame. It sort of contributes to the friendly look of the car, but I have seen some photos of the new X5 with tinted windows and I think it just looks better. At the rear we've got some huge exhaust tips in the bumper with an exhaust pipe in there. We've got some badging also in the same that ferric gray color, and I'll also show you the boot. We've got a split tailgate, which is power opening and power closing, with some more space underneath there. And I think this is a first. We've got an electric retracting cover. So you can use this button to move it forwards and back. Of course, if you close it, it goes all the way to me. But we can push this button and the little thing opens there and it disappears, which is kind of cool. And now if you fold down the seats like that, you have a completely flat bed if you put that seat a little bit forward, which is kind of cool that they invented this automatically disappearing and raising boot cover. So, all right. As I said, it's power closing as well, so you can push this button and the lower part goes up. You can press that and it goes down. You can also do it with your foot, I think. No, yeah, you can. They both open. Pretty cool. I love a split tailgate. Especially when it works. Thank you. All right. So in the rear, we've got Tartufo interior, which is one of our favorites, with BMW individual leather. So it's really soft with these nice stitchings and a nice soft headrest as well. We've got entertainment in the rear, which is now a touchscreen, finally. I think that took a little bit too long, but you can now use your fingers. It's great that it's finally a touchscreen, because I think that took way too long. We've also got this sort of wood, Escher wood, I think, with Bowers & Wilkins diamond audio, which is an option, which is incredible. And we've got this two-tone, so we've got black and Tartufo. We'll take a look at the engine. There it is, M Performance, 3-liter inline six quad turbo with 400 horsepower and 760 newton meters. It is a great drive train, as I said. We've even driven a tuned one with 515 horsepower with just an ECU tune, just a chip. So, you know, imagine doing that to this car and you'd have something totally mental. M50D badge down there. So the interior, it's largely the same as in the new 8 series we drove recently. This is, and of course the screen is as well, with the new iDrive 7, which works great. I still really like this. You get a nice car in the same color. That's great. But again, I'll say it again, I don't really like this. I think there are a lot of people who will like it, but this sort of Swarovski glass crystal, I don't really like it. I think it's a bit too flashy for BMW, to be honest. But the worst thing is that if you don't get this, then you get this cheap black plastic thing, and I don't like that either. So I would go for this, I guess. If I had the choice. More wood, more Tartufo, great comfort seats. And we've got the new digital instrument cluster over there as well, which I don't really like. I'm not the biggest fan of this stuff. I think it's not that clear and easy to read. And I think it's a bit much for an X5. I would have liked to see them go a little bit more classic for an SUV. And as you can see, there's a little weird thing right there. That's actually a camera that spies on your face when you engage the driver assistant mode. And it actually analyzes your face and it watches if you are turning your head. So if you have the driver assistant stuff on and you let go of the steering wheel, you get a notification on there that you should grab the steering wheel. But also if you are not looking at the road for too long, it also gives you a notification, which is pretty cool. So new for this generation X5 is that all the diesel engines get this sort of sound engineered sound through the speakers, and the X5 M50D has it even louder. So if you go for comfort mode, which we are in right now, and you rev it, it sounds like a diesel six cylinder. But if you go for sport plus or sport, it might actually be a sound actuator like in the Audi SQ7, because that's really loud. All right, let's take it for a drive. Because the X5 has always been one of the best handling SUVs out there. And, you know, I think only the Porsche Cayenne handles better on the road. And it has been like that for ages. I think like 20 years ago, the first BMW X5 came out. And it really impressed with the road handling. It was sort of the first SUV that handled well on the road. So every time they come out with a new one, this is the fourth generation, they still have to drive nicely on the road. So before we continue with that, we are going to do a 0 to 100 test with our GPS performance box, which you can buy in our store, linked in the top right corner. So I've got it up here. You can see it connected really quickly. And that means that it's ready to go. So, as I said, 400 horsepower, 760 newton meters. It should do 5.2 seconds to 100. We'll go for sport mode, ESP in sport mode as well. Foot on the brake, full throttle. There we go. Lurches forward on the shifts, and that's a 5.35. It's close enough to 5.2. So as I said, we are going to continue on the driving, because this M50D is actually something special, because the normal X5, so like the 30Ds, the 40Is, they all get air suspension as standard, but not the M50D. This one gets steel coilover springs, just regular springs with adaptive dampers, because they say, you know, this is an M Performance, so it should handle a little bit better. And you can actually slide it around, apparently. I was not expecting that at all. But that was actually pretty nice. So it is really rear wheel biased, this xDrive system. That was pretty intense. Okay. Yeah, so it actually produces some sound. Continuing my line of thought, it actually has regular springs, and that means that it's a lot more hunkered down. That means you have a lot more connection to the road, and it's sort of their way to try and make this car handle a lot better. You also get active anti-roll bars on the M50D if you go for the M Sport Adaptive Professional package. I hope I said that correctly. To make it even stiffer, to really, you know, counter the body roll, which you are inevitably going to have in a 2.2 ton SUV. But handling wise, there's only one thing that sort of makes it weird, which is that you can also get four-wheel steering on this car. We've talked about this before. It is really nice because your low speed maneuverability improves by a lot, but it can also feel a little bit weird. So like when you turn into a corner, it really turns in really quickly because the wheels, the rear wheels steer against the front wheels. Okay, so we are on the unrestricted autobahn. We can do a test here. The funny thing about these M50Ds has always been that they never really feel that fast until you look down at your speedometer, because they are fast and they are relentless. And especially this new quad turbo, it just feels like it likes to rev a lot more. You know, as opposed to most diesel engines that are sort of hesitant to go over, let's say, 3000 RPM. Okay, so we are actually already at the top speed. That's 256. M Sport brakes, really nice as well. But it handles itself really well on the autobahn. I mean, this is sort of what it's made for, apart from the fact that the air suspension would make it more comfortable. But it feels really fast, and every time I drive one of these cars, I'm impressed by how well this engine works and by how smooth it is with those four turbos. So you've got two low pressure ones and two high pressure ones, and they sort of work together to give you the best performance at any given moment. 259. Starts to move around a little bit now. 260. That's the top speed. Of course, it's a big car, so the wind does have an effect on your stability at these high speeds. But something that the BMW engineers have succeeded at again is that it just feels like a regular car. It doesn't feel like such a big car, and that's an achievement, because it did grow by quite a lot. It's longer, it's wider, it's higher. This car is actually wider than the new BMW X7. Can you believe that? So it is a big car, but it doesn't really feel like that. Something I don't really like about this new generation is, as I said, the fact that it does look very similar to an X3. But something else is that in here, I don't really feel like I'm in an X5. I think it's a bit too polished. I think it's a bit too, this is a bit too low, which means that you sort of feel like you sit on top of it. And I would have liked it to feel a little bit more, you know, like an SUV. But this is still incredible, and although I personally prefer the looks of the previous X5, you know, this does look a lot more modern. And if you would put them next to each other right now, I think the old one would look very old, because it does look a lot sleeker, this car. And this new drivetrain is a lot better than before as well. I really would prefer this drivetrain over the old M50D with 381 horsepower, the tri-turbo setup. It's also more comfortable, it's more spacious, it's more luxurious. I mean, oh my God. I'm so sorry, people of Germany. I will tell him not to come to Germany anymore and not drive 110.98 on the unrestricted Autobahn. So sorry. Another one, a caravaner. I'm so sorry, guys. And as I said in the beginning, can you imagine having this car with 515 horsepower and over like 900 newton meters if you chip tune it? I mean, that is just a ridiculous car, and I have to say that that does really make me want one. So it's a bit weird. When I first saw this car in pictures, I thought, ooh, no thank you. Then I sort of got used to it, got used to the new big grille, got used to the new rear end, and then I saw it for the first time in person, and I was like, I don't know if this is the way BMW should go, but I'm sort of getting used to it. And I think that if you spec it in the right way, at least I would, you know, tint the windows, I would maybe go for a little bit darker color, maybe like a dark green, keep the same interior, maybe a different wood. I think you can really make this car look a lot better. And that big grille, I mean, we are just going to get used to it. So I think in a couple of months, no one will complain about that anymore. So that's it for this review. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right here. You can also check out this review of that BMW M550D with 515 horsepower I told you about, or you can check out this playlist. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you at the next one. Bye.